Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, let's see the next example of Turing machine. Over here, we are constructing a Turing machine which would act like a subtractor. Given two numbers x and y, we need to find x minus y. Again, we are considering that the numbers are given in unary format. One more consideration is that number x is always greater than y, so we have always a positive result. Let's take x is equal to 4, y is equal to 3. Over here, what I'll do is, I'll use the same operation which I did earlier, that is replacing the number of 1s with x as compared to number of x and y's. Whenever I'm done with this, I'll be replicating the number of 1s in the number y to the number of 1s in number x. Remaining 1s would be the result of subtraction. Let's see an example. Let's say the separator is 0. First, I replace a 1 with an x. Along with that, we have one more replacement from the right-hand side. Similarly, let's do the next. You will see that finally I am left with 1, 1. And that is my subtraction result. Now, let us try to emulate this in a machine. Taking Q0 as the initial state. With the first 1, I'll replace it with x and move to the next state and keep on moving to the right. After the first replacement, all the 1s are skipped till we reach the second number. 0 will represent the middle of the string. After that, we might encounter some number of x's. When we see the first 1, replace it with x and keep on moving to the left. Again, we'll skip all the x's while coming back to the left. Whenever we see 0, we know that we have reached the middle of the string. Again, we'll skip all the 1s. Whenever we see the first x, we know that we have encountered the end of the list of 1s, so we'll move to the right. You will see that this much working of the Turing machine is similar to the one that we discussed earlier. After this, there is a change. From Q2, we have introduced the state which represents number 2 is greater than number 1. Similarly, from Q0, we have introduced some states to check whether the numbers are equal or else the second number is greater. But over here, we are sure that the first number is always greater, and hence we are skipping that particular situation. From Q2, when we reach a blank symbol, we know that the particular string on the right is finished. We need to trace back to the first number and we have to replace the one which has replaced in the last one because there is no matching one. We can go back and again replace the last x with a 1. This will start going back. On the path, we need to skip all x's. Similarly, we need to skip the 0. Now we'll start stretching the string x. Now we'll start getting the strings of 1s and x's. We need to ignore them. Finally, in the case of the next 1, we will have to come back and make the x to be again 1. I'm making the transition in a new sheet. Now, whenever we see the first x, we need to replace that x with 1. Now we included one more 1 onto the string. Now the number of 1s in the tape represents x minus y. One more way this could have achieved is using replacing a blank onto the left of x by using a 1. We could have done that as well. We have seen Turing machine as adder, subtractor, comparator, etc. Now let us see an example in which Turing machine is used as a copier. That means it will copy data from one portion of the tape to the other portion. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and do subscribe.